AWA Championship Wrestling. The AWA presents the greatest stars in professional wrestling, bringing you the best in mat action.
A very happy new year, everybody. Lee Marshall and Ralph Strangis, welcome to Championship Wrestling on ESPN, your total sports network. Starting out the brand new year, the return of Yukon John.
Yukon John, he's promoting a kindler, gentler Yukon John Nord for the 80s, the end of the 80s into the 90s, but we'll see.
On the other end of the scale, the bad guys out of Texas, the Texas Hangman.
Oh, they're tough. They're tough. And we'll see. They want to get down to business. We will see so today.
Equally bad from Japan, the Masa Saito is coming in.
Masa Saito, we've seen him before, and his techniques are, well, strange to some, but, well, to others, just plain crucifying.
Now, I come from California. You live in California. You know all about earthquakes.
Yes.
In our main event, you are going to see a main event featuring Coquina Maximus.
And Coquina Maximus, I'll tell you, Greg Gagne's in Hawaii, and lucky Greg Gagne's in Hawaii because he had some words about Coquina Maximus, and he's going to be throwing his weight up. Big guys throwing their weight around.
In fact, the earth moves every time the man enters the arena. All that and so much more coming up for you on Championship Wrestling on ESPN. Don't you dare go away.
Wrestling on ESPN. I'm Eric Bischoff, and I'd like to take this opportunity to wish everyone out there a very, very happy new year. Now, you heard Ralph and Lee earlier talk about today's main event, big Yukon John Nord in a body slam match against 475-pound Coquina Maximus. And that's the question in my mind. As big as Yukon John is, can he pick up a man the size of Coquina? We'll find out later on in the main event. But right now, let's take a look at the first match of today's program. Tommy Jammer, the ladies' favorite. Let's get over to the ring for the announcements.
This event is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Detroit City, here is Bad Boy Brown. His opponent hails from San Diego, California. Here is the California Kid, Tommy Jammer.
Lee Marshall and ringside Ralph, and what you got here on ESPN, your total sports station is ringside Ralph. What I was trying to say was
yes.
Surf City against the Motor City.
Boy, I'll tell you, what a way to start the new year, huh, Lee Marshall? Motown and Beach Town.
Motown and Surf City.
And Surf City.
There you go.
I like that better. Surf City, okay, the neon green must tell me that Tommy Jammer's the guy from the beach.
That's right.
Okay.
You're sharp as a tack, Ralph.
I'm dressed to kill.
And ready for the new year. Here we go. Collar and elbow. Jammer, he's working Brown into the corner. Muscle him around. Jammer's going to put him in. Garusha says, break it up. I had enough of this.
Tommy Jammer, kid from the beaches, built for flash. There's a lot of skateboarding. Really, and he says that it helps his footwork and his leg speed.
It does. He does do a lot of skateboarding. He does a lot of legitimate surfing as well. I don't know he's going to go challenge the Bonsai Pipeline, and that's nobody's sidewalk now. Left foot in the midsection, and down goes Bad Boy Brown. Jammer stands him upright, takes him up for the big body slam. Bam!
Yeah, there he goes.
Brown. Tommy's saying, come on, get up. I got plenty more for you. Into the turnbuckle. Jammer takes Brown.
Brown is dazed and confused.
You better believe it.
You betcha.
That's not the name of an accounting firm either.
No. Not the name of a label that comes out of Detroit either.
No. Uh-huh. He's got him in the abdominal stretch. This could be all. I've seen Jammer put this on before.
You bet.
I think he might have him.
Check him, yep.
Vern Gagne taught him how to do that abdominal stretch, and he taught him well.
Tommy Jammer, the California Kid, over Bad Boy Brown.
It wasn't that long ago Tommy Jammer went to Vern Gagne and said, champ, I need a little help. I need something that's really going to put me over the top. He said, let me show you this move. It's called the abdominal stretch, and Jammer can do it. We're going to be right back.
Where can you go for the parts you need?
Pick and Pull self-service auto dismantlers. In fact, I'm going there now.
Pick and Pull has thousands of cars with
A few fans that have been watching big UConn John Nord since he's returned here to the AWA, you've heard him make it very, very clear that he and Bertha are here for one thing, and that's to clear out all the bad timber in the AWA. Well, we're going to get a double dose of the Big Lumberjack today, not only in the main event, but let's take a look at a match that the Big Lumberjack had not too long ago with the Menace.
The following event is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from parts unknown, he is the Menace. His opponent hails from the great northern woods. Please welcome UConn John.
Strategist on ESPN, your Total Sports Network. Happy 1990. Got to use that down on the checks and everything.
Yes,
now, right?
I'm still writing BC on my checks. Tell you where my head's at.
What do they say? If there's checks in the book, there's money in the bank.
That's right.
That's right.
Something like that. It is the 90s.
Yep.
Want to welcome everybody to a new decade of All-Star Wrestling.
That's right. Right here on ESPN Championship Wrestling, and that includes Big UConn John Nord, who has made a New Year's resolution. I mean, this guy used to run in some pretty tough company.
Yeah.
He used to hang out with Bruiser Brody. He used to hang out with the likes of the late Adrian Adonis.
Yeah.
He used to just like to roughhouse it, kick tail and take names, and really not care very much about the feelings of anybody else. But somehow that's changed. He's a new man. He said, yeah, I'm still rough. I'm still tough. But I'm a little bit different. I read the Bible now. I have a sense of fair play about me. And it's not saying that I still don't want to be champion of the world, but he won't go to any ends to get it now, Ralph.
And going to work for John Nord has meant carrying the axe, Bertha,
into
the Northwest Territories. He's very reluctant to give it up.
Yeah, I know that.
Even in the ring, you notice that. Yeah.
Yeah, he doesn't like to give that axe up. The axe he calls Bertha. But this is a man that has gone up to the Northern Territories, up in Yukon, and he has been a lumberjack. He has worked hard.
And the Menace.
Yep. Oh.
My.
It's like running into one of those trees.
Yeah.
Menace finding out right away that Big UConn John means business as he plants that size 18 into the UConn's kisser.
And there's the wolf howl.
Yep.
There's the wolf howl.
And everybody in the arena gets going to it. Woo! They love UConn John when he goes into that wolf howl.
And UConn John, he's a working man from up in the Northwest Territories wearing his blue jeans.
Yep. He's big enough to be a wolf, to be a timber wolf. He can play for Bill Musselman's expansion Timberwolf team. He's big enough. Oh, look at that drop kick.
Timber.
And Timber,
man.
Indeed.
Wow.
He did.
Ooh, there it is again. UConn John Nord.
Ooh, headbutt into the midsection.
Ushering in the decade of the 90s with, I'll say it again, a kinder, gentler John Nord.
Well, we'll have a look at that.
I know.
So far, he's had his way pretty much with the Menace. And here he comes, UConn John, stalking. Just like he would probably stalk for his dinner up in the UConn. Going after the Menace.
The Menace, you can never tell these guys that wear the mask, if they're in trouble, what the expression on their face is.
Thundering right forearm by UConn John. Picks him up, setting him up for the big body slam. He's got him up, and pretty soon he is going to take him down.
When? Okay, I'm ready.
It's a runner. It's a running
slam. Oh, my.
The whole building shook, Ralph.
There comes the howls.
And there goes UConn John.
Now, here's how he likes to do it.
This is what he uses to set up that big guillotine leg drop. And here it comes.
Oh.
And that could be all for the Menace. One, two, three, that's it. Another win for UConn John. He is undefeated since his return to the AWA.
Big UConn John Nord is your winner. Unbeaten. And boy, he said he was coming back, and he is coming back, and here is how he likes to get it done.
Back and forth across the ring he goes. One more time. Kaboom off the ropes. One more big bounce off the ropes, and here comes the big guillotine. Bang!
Wow.
That's going to be it. A win for UConn John and a visitor with Eric Bischoff.
Well,
Well, there he is, the big lumberjack, a former member of Sheik Adnan LKC's army, and we'll see him later on today in the main event when he gets a chance to body slam the man Sheik Adnan LKC is currently managing. We're talking about Coquina Maximus. Well, stay tuned, because right after this break, the Texas Hangmen are coming your way. We'll be right back.
The American Wrestling Association is currently on tour all across the country and in cities just like yours. AWA Championship Professional Wrestling is absolutely the hottest attraction in any city today. If you're an independent promoter, county fair, or facility looking to draw a crowd with a bang, call the AWA Promotion Center at 612-545-9376. For all the exciting details, when you're serious about quality professional wrestling, it's the AWA, the Major League of Professional Wrestling.
Back in the arena already, the cowbells are clanging. That can only mean one thing. The Texas Hangmen are about ready to do battle. So let's get over to the ring for the announcements.
The following tag team event is scheduled for one fall. Introducing this tag team first, from Honolulu, Hawaii, here is Jimmy Magnum. His tag team partner hails from Reno, Nevada. He is Red Tyler. Their opponents entering the arena this time hail from Waco, Texas. Here are Psycho and Killer, the Texas Hangmen.
Psycho and Killer all the way from Waco, Texas. The Texas Hangmen there in there with Red Tyler and Jimmy Packham. I tell you what, the Texas Hangmen. Those of you who have been following the Team Challenge series, you read all about it in all the wrestling magazines. We've talked to you about it on ESPN. But they say once that they have no longer have need to be focused on the Team Challenge series, they want a shot at the Destruction Crew. They want to be tag team champions of the world.
And, well, they are moving in that direction. They are making quick work of some of their earlier opponents. They are tough. They are also, you know, the kind of wrestlers that you look at and you say, oh my, just their appearance alone is frightening. That's Killer, isn't it, on this right there?
Well, I was going to say, you and I joked about that a couple of weeks ago. The truth is, they look so much alike.
They do.
It's so difficult to tell, and that makes Gary DeRusha's job as the referee more difficult, and certainly as a other combatant trying to figure out who you're in there with, that's also quite difficult. Red Tyler, all we can say is that he is in there with one of the Texas Hangmen.
Kid from Reno is rolling the dice.
Oh, you bet he is. Taking a big chance that he's not going to get hurt, because that's another thing about the Texas Hangmen. They enjoy their work, and they like to hurt people. And they're successful at it, too. Big right hand by the Texas Hangmen. Snapmare, down goes Red Tyler. Oh, knee to the top of the head.
It's an old saying that these guys forgot more about dispensing pain than any of the other wrestlers will ever know.
Oh, well, it's a thing about professional wrestling. We've stated it time and time again. Not only had you better be able to dish it out, but by God, you better be able to take it. Otherwise, you've got no business being in this.
That's absolutely right.
And now, on the side of the ring, one of the Texas Hangmen running Red Tyler into the ring apron. Gary DeRusha says, get away from him. Come on. One at a time.
They're going after Red Tyler. His partner, Jimmy Magnum, is just out of the picture.
Well, Jimmy
can't get into it at all.
Jimmy Magnum is a much bigger man. You know, Jimmy's about 302 pounds, 6'7". And I can see the Texas Hangman strategy.
Look at this.
I mean, not suggesting Red Tyler's some kind of lightweight. He's about 6'3", 240 pounds. But you got to think that the Hangman say, well, let's go up to the smaller of the guys and see if we can take the pinfall on Red Tyler. Tyler's got to get out of there. He's got to find a way to get Magnum into this match.
And that, because that may be a mistake of strategy. You know, perhaps they might have wanted Magnum in first. It's hard. It's almost like in hockey where you have the last change.
Right, exactly. You know? Now, the one thing that they are doing right, Ralph, is keeping Red Tyler in their corner.
Yeah.
They're not giving him a chance to tag off.
See, and they know that. They know they don't want to use Magnum. This is the guy they want to finish. They'd like to do this without ever seeing Jimmy Magnum.
Exactly. It has happened. And the Texas Hangmen are the kind of team that can do it. And look at the punishment they're dealing in the midsection of Red Tyler.
Yeah.
That is Killer in the ring, we've been told.
Killer has the red right boot.
No, you want to know?
Has the red left boot.
You want to know how to tell?
No.
Killer does not have an arm pad on. If you look, you can see Psycho
has the arm pad.
Has the arm pad. And now Killer, he's going after Jimmy Magnum. Said, all right, come on, big boy. You want a piece of the action? Come on and get it.
Spun Tyler around like a child's toy.
Oh my. What a move they put on Red Tyler. One, two,
three.
Good night.
Magnum was in for about 4 seconds.
Yeah. And I don't know if he was ever really legally in.
Well, I don't think so.
Well, we mentioned that there was a possibility the Hangman would do that. It's good strategy. They kept Red Tyler in their corner the entire match. And when they had the opportunity, they took him down with that devastating move. Now you can see Magnum, he's trying to get into the ring. You're right, he did not tag in.
No, never got into the picture at all.
Now,
this allowing Killer to deliver the finishing blow with his partner Psycho coming in off the ropes. Boom, bang, bomb.
From that point, it's strictly academic. Hook of the leg, up on the toes. Gary DeRusso, the referee, down for the 1-2-3. And that, as they say, is that. We're going to check in now with Eric Bischoff.
Texas Hangman, and I've said it before, a very tough, unpredictable team, and I'm sure they've got tag team championships on their mind. But Paul Hard Rock Diamond, next week, you're going to be facing the Texas Hangman in a special six-man tag team challenge series main event. How are you feeling about that?
Well, that's right, and the one thing you failed to mention, Eric, too, it is a battle royal. And what that means, the only way you can be eliminated is if you get thrown over the top rope, and you're probably flying 10 feet in the air and landing on a concrete floor. Well, let me tell you something. Many careers have ended over this, and many injuries do happen in this type of a match. So Tommy Jammer and myself, we're preparing for this match because we want to win it. Because if you win it, that's the only way you can avoid being thrown over the top rope onto the concrete floor.
Well, let me ask you. Obviously, you're in excellent physical condition. Your partner, Tommy Jammer, equally impressive in the physique department. But how are you going to approach the unpredictable tactics of the Texas Hangman?
Well, there is the Texas Hangman. There's also Johnny Stewart and Doug Summers involved as well. So we got four guys. I've had a thing with Johnny Stewart for a long, long time, so I know he's going to be after me. But as long as Jam and I work as a team, if we can, when one of us is in trouble, the other one comes and helps, I think we can handle all four of them. And you're going to see Jammer and Hard Rock Paul Diamond standing tall in the middle of the ring.
That's next week, and we'll be back right after this.
The American Wrestling Association is currently on tour all across the country and in cities.
Back. And fans, just a reminder, on January 8th at 4 o'clock Eastern, the entire card here on AWA Championship Wrestling is going to be devoted to the Team Challenge Series style matches. It's great action. Whatever you do, don't miss it. Mark it on your calendar. And a man who's going to be involved in the main event, a six-man battle royale, that's Paul Hard Rock Diamond. We heard from him right before the break. But now, for you fans that may have missed it not too long ago, the heavyweight champion of the world, Larry Zbyszko, signed to meet a man that, well, he thought it was the Unknown Soldier, and indeed it was. The rub came in where the Unknown Soldier also turned out to be none other than Mr. Saito, the man from Japan that's here in the U.S. to try to take the title away from Larry Zbyszko. And in case you missed it, let's take a look again. Mr. Saito, the Unknown Soldier, and Larry Zbyszko.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent tonight, from parts unknown, here is the Unknown Soldier!
Say that Larry Zbyszko's right, but let's just say he's got reason for argument. The living legend says that's not the Unknown Soldier. Well, we've seen the Unknown Soldier a couple of times.
Yeah.
This is a plot by Sergeant Slaughter! Shut up, soldier! You suck! Each and every one of you suck! That's not the Unknown Soldier!
Larry Zbyszko, you signed a contract to face the Unknown Soldier. This man is licensed to wrestle as the Unknown Soldier.
Uh,
Zbyszko, he's hot.
I don't blame him.
I don't know that I blame him either, Ralph. Right here on ESPN, your total sports network, your main event, the living legend, Larry Zbyszko, and
the unknown soldier.
And the unknown soldier,
that's all we can say.
That's
all we can say.
You heard Eric Bischoff a second ago say, get in there. You signed a contract to meet the unknown soldier. This man is licensed as the unknown soldier. Get the belt off.
I don't know. It just does not look like the unknown soldier we saw earlier. They're handing the belt. Zbyszko's got to get into the ring.
I understand that. Gary DeRusha, the third man in the ring. Oh, this young man has refereed so many championship matches. Here comes the living legend.
Blade.
Zbyszko, he says this isn't the unknown soldier. The AWA Championship Committee says there's a match to take place between Larry Zbyszko and the unknown soldier for the heavyweight championship of the world. Into the turnbuckle goes the unknown soldier.
Slide,
and down goes the legend.
Oh, and off comes the mask.
It's Saito. Mr. Saito.
From Japan. It is Mr. Saito now.
Master Saito going to work on the living legend.
Very
and down goes Zbyszko.
Up high with the chop to the throat. Very versed in the kendo stick. You know that, but today it's bare hands.
Crushing headbutt by Mr. Saito, and he wants to be heavyweight champion of the world. And I'll tell you what a match. Mr. Saito and Larry Zbyszko, you call him the unknown soldier, you call him Mr. Saito, whatever you call him, you better call him a man who can take that championship away from Larry Zbyszko. If the stars are right and the planets are in line and Lady Luck is riding with him, this is a guy who can take Zbyszko all the way downtown.
And since the harmonic convergence, he has certainly been wrestling better.
Absolutely. I noticed that as well. Saito, he is all over Zbyszko. You're seeing two guys that, I'll tell you quite honestly, I'm delighted it was Mr. Saito under that unknown soldier.
I am too. You know, to tell you the truth, when we heard that the unknown soldier was coming in, I thought, well, the guy at most could, you know, maybe run away from Zbyszko for
exactly.
A little while. But here's somebody tying him up like a pretzel.
Got his leg grapevine going into the scorpion. And I'll tell you, if he can turn him over, he's going to put a whole lot of pressure. You're going to hear some pop pops, and those are going to be the kneecaps of Larry Zbyszko. If Saito can just roll him over a little bit more, he's got him down. If he can get that left arm out from under him and put him into almost a full Boston crab, push up by Zbyszko.
Not enough.
He's fighting his way out.
Not enough.
Referee asking Zbyszko if he wants to give it up. He says no, no, no.
No, sir. I tell you, the world champion isn't going to give his belt away like this.
He goes for the ropes.
He may not have a choice, however.
Oh, I don't know.
Saito is definitely working on him, and the living legend clutching the midsection.
Into the turnbuckle goes Zbyszko. Saito has had Zbyszko compromised a couple of times. Into the bear hug. Look at that side suplex, and down goes Zbyszko, and this arena rocked. And this arena is loving it.
One.
Two.
Two. Up.
Kick out at two.
Come on.
Got shoulder out. Up at
yep.
Two.
Yep, got out.
You know, Nick Bockwinkle told me something once, Ralph. He said, in my sleep, if somebody came to my bed and hit the mattress twice, I'd lift my shoulder up. And I think that's what Larry Zbyszko did, just instinctively getting his shoulder up at the two count. The other thing that you've got to think about, too, Ralph, is that if you gave a contract to Larry Zbyszko that had Mr. Saito's name on it, I don't think he'd sign it.
No. No, I don't think so either.
So Zbyszko's got far more than he bargained for as Mr. Saito in there looking to take the heavyweight championship of the world right off the shoulders and right off the waist of the living legend, Larry Zbyszko.
So from that standpoint, Lee, perhaps it's better an unpromoted event. It got him in the ring.
It sure did.
Got him in the ring. It got Saito in the ring again.
Look at this. Oh,
my.
Tremendous. That's a textbook suplex.
Yeah, you
Nobody
bet.
Does it better.
One. Two.
He's got him. No,
no
kick out by Saito.
I'm glad we're on
ESPN. Millions of people all around the world getting an opportunity to see a match for the heavyweight championship of the world. Look at that. Zbyszko telegraphing it just a split second too early, and you can't do that with Masa Saito.
And you know the phones are ringing in Tokyo.
Oh, you better believe it. You better believe it.
Look who's on. Look who's on, they're saying. Yeah, and some phones are ringing in maybe Larry's head, eh?
I think that's absolutely right. Saito's about ready to answer it. He rams Zbyszko into the into the post, and now Zbyszko's got a hold of Gary DeRusha. He's got a hold of Gary DeRusha.
Bell rings, and so does Zbyszko off the iron.
Well, he was all over DeRusha. I don't quite understand what... Now look at this, there's Dave Casper. Dave Casper.
Casper coming in to help out the living legend.
Well, I don't know if he's here to help out.
I don't know what he's... Legend. Well, he's...
Stop Saito.
I don't know what's going on now.
You got Tommy Jammer out there. I mean, you just got a whole bunch of bodies out there.
Uh-oh.
There's the Texas Hangman.
Killer and Psycho, respectively.
What is... Okay. Here comes Saito. He's going after Zbyszko.
And now it's
Casper's
a free
in
ball.
It. Jammer's in it. The Texas...
The Unknown Soldier making himself very well known to the heavyweight champion of the world. And Mr. Saito is scheduled next in a match with Todd Becker. So let's get over to the ring for the announcements. Mr. Saito.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, here is Todd Becker. His opponent hails from Tokyo, Japan. Please welcome Mr. Saito.
Masa Saito, tip of the scales at 271 pounds. In there with Todd Becker out of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Once again, Happy New Year, everybody. Glad you're with us today on ESPN, your total sports network. Mr. Saito, Todd Becker. Gary DeRusha, the third man, and he calls for the bell, and here we go, Ralph.
Mr. Saito is coming in, and he's going to show some martial arts here to Todd Becker, 46 pounds heavier, and also Mr. Saito is a man with, well, maybe a few more bags in his trick. Tricks in his bag.
Well, you
or bags in
it.
His trick, or, you know what I mean.
When you say, yes, I do, when you say Saito's going to show him a martial arts lesson, I agree, he is a fifth-degree black belt,
yeah.
But I'll tell you what, he can show you all kinds of moves, just straight catch-as-catch-can wrestling, Greco-Roman freestyle. Right now, he's got him hooked up in a nice amateur move, got the arm bar and stretched out. If he reaches back, he can break by the leg and really put Becker into a submission hold.
Well, Saito is, of late, has had some interesting appearances.
Mm-hmm.
Came out as the Unknown Soldier a little while ago.
Do you remember that challenge, Larry Zbyszko?
I'll tell you, he came out, he had the hood on, the mask on. We all thought that it was the Unknown Soldier.
Nice takedown by Saito, followed by a boot to the back.
But then it turned out, of course, to be Saito.
He was going for the hip toss. Just caught Becker in the midsection and took the air out of him instead.
Might want to mention.
Oh, man.
But
don't forget, we've got a main event featuring Kokina. And we're still not sure if he's going to be here to see John Nord, UConn John.
Well, with the holiday traffic, his plane was delayed in the Chicago area, and we don't know exactly which airport he was flying out of, but anyone who's flown out of Chicago,
matter.
It doesn't matter.
Midway, doesn't matter. O'Hare, doesn't matter.
He might be still stuck in the cab on the way to the airport, for all we know about that. We will find out from the Sheik a little bit later what's going to happen with the main event, and now let's find out what's happening inside the ring.
It's all business for Meister Saito inside the ring. That's what's going on, Ralph. Todd Becker, he's just getting pummeled, pillar to post by Mr. Saito. Another chop into the pectoral area of Todd Becker. Picking him up. I think he's going for that side suplex.
He got
him
with
it. Yeah, buddy. He nailed him.
One, two, and three. That's all. Masa Saito, 271 pounds from Tokyo, Japan. Making quick work of Todd Becker, who still lays immobile.
He does that so quick. When you see Mr. Saito take that position, swing that hit into the side, you know that the side suplex is coming up. Watch him. He gets it, drives his shoulder in, moves his hip to the side, boom, plants, and takes Becker down, bango.
Wow.
And a 1-2-3, and that's going to be all.
Oh, boy.
We're going to be right back right after this.
Here's first of all the main event that's coming up later on in the program. Big UConn John Nord in a body slam match with 475-pound Kokina Maximus. And on January 8th, 4 o'clock Eastern, right here on ESPN, the AWA presents an entire card of Team Challenge Series style matches. Don't miss it, whatever you do. And talk about the Team Challenge Series, Lee Marshall is standing by with a current update on the standings in the Team Challenge Series. How about it, Lee?
Thanks very much, Eric. Next Monday, January 8th, 4 p.m. Eastern Time, AWA Championship Wrestling fans will be treated to three Team Challenge Series style matches. Matches included are an amateur-style Greco-Roman contest featuring Wayne the Train Bloom and a former amateur great, Baron Von Raschke. Also, a special football battle between two former football standouts. Mean Mike Enos will face the Trooper with a special guest referee from the football world. The main event will be a six-man tag team battle royal featuring the Texas Hangman, Paul Diamond and Tommy Jammer, and Johnny Stewart and the Unknown Soldier. These Team Challenge Series style matches will show the intensity and camaraderie, the desire and the teamwork and the constant action that typifies the hottest concept in all of professional wrestling, the Team Challenge Series. Tune in next Monday, January 8th at 4 p.m. Eastern Time for all the action.
The AWA leading the way in professional wrestling in the 1990s with the Team Challenge Series. And you'll get a chance to see that great action next week right here on ESPN. Well, stay tuned because after this break, I have a chance to talk to Sheik Adnan LKC. We'll be right back.
Tuned because coming up in the main event, we're going to see the big man, Kokina Maximus, and standing by his manager, if you will, Sheik Adnan LKC. Is Kokina ready?
Yes, he's ready, and here is our... Now he's going to go on the ring, and he's going to destroy anybody that steps in the ring with him. But at the minute, he's not here yet, because it's snowing everywhere in the country. There's a snow falling.
Wait a minute. Are you trying to say Kokina Maximus is not here right at this moment?
Well, at the moment, he's not here, but he will be here if I have to get a Learjet anywhere in the world and fly him back here. He will be here, because it's snowing everywhere in the world. There is a snow, and it's snow. I cannot understand it.
Okay, stay tuned. Coming up in the main event, Big John Nord, Yukon John, and someone. We'll be right back.
Which wrestler recently suffered a personal tragedy? You've got to pick up the phone and call me now.
Hi, I'm Vern Gagne, and if you want to hear my wrestling prediction for the 1990s, call me now.
Well, it's time for that New Year's resolution, Spudhead. Get to Larryland! And like last week, Spudhead of the Week, you won't believe who it is this time, and you call me now.
Who was the best wrestling manager of 1989 according to Wrestling Insiders? If you'd like to know, call me, Matt Burns, now.
So you've always wanted to be a wrestling promoter. Well, now's your chance. Call the fan line and tell us the kind of match you want to see.
We heard Sheik Adnan LKC right before the break. Yes, he admitted Kokina Maximus, at least at that time, was not in the arena. Now, we know Yukon John Nord, he's ready to participate. We don't know if Kokina Maximus has made it to the ring or even made it to the arena yet. So without any further delay, let's go to the main event. Yukon John Norton, what we think is going to be Kokina Maximus.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your matchup. Introducing first, weighing in at 255 pounds, he hails from Baghdad, Iraq. Here is Sheik Adnan LKC. His opponent weighs in at 308 pounds. He is from the Great Northern Woods. Here is Yukon John Nord.
and gentlemen, this is a Team Challenge Series match, and the rules are very, very simple. This is going to be a slam match. Pinfalls do not count. Submissions do not count. Countouts do not count. Only slams count. The first man to slam
the other,
either in the ring or outside the ring, is the winner.
We are trying to make some obvious confusion here. Bob Ryan, legal counsel with
the
AWA. The
misunderstanding is it's supposed to be the Queen of Maxima. It's my team at stake, and she's not supposed to be in there.
Coquina Maximus is not here. Do I understand that right?
Coquina Maximus is not in the ring area. Sheik Adnan El Casey is the Coquina's manager and signed as the second. Sheik Adnan El Casey will go in the ring. And
all right, that's it.
Hey, you didn't win it. You suck.
That's it. Sheik Adnan El Casey taking the place of Coquina Maximus. He must wrestle in this match. I'm out of here.
He doesn't even belong out here. Get him out of here.
Well, you see it. Sheik Adnan El Casey has been pointed in the direction of the ring. He's having words right now with lots of people, including Bob Ryan, the legal counsel of the AWA. Larry Zbyszko, also a member of that entourage. Confusion galore here, Lee Marshall, as the Sheik has been pointed into the ring.
Right.
And earlier in today's program, the Sheik was confident
that Coquina would be here.
That he would be here.
That was my understanding.
Yeah, mine too.
I was up in the ring. Now, does all this mean that Coquina's not here?
I guess so. Bob Ryan made the announcement that Coquina Maxima is not in the ring area.
Now, look. Baron Von Raschke has Yukon John's wolf hat on. Very flattering.
Well, I'll tell you, what a way to start the new year. This is January 1st. Happy New Year.
Yes, indeed.
Maybe Coquina was out on amateur night having too much fun. I don't know.
Maybe so. But in the meantime, Sheik Adnan El Casey, apparently. Now, you correct me if I'm wrong here, Ralph. I mean, I was in the ring and really didn't hear everything. Sheik Adnan El Casey must
get into the ring
with Yukon John
in a slam match.
Yeah, pinfalls don't count.
Uh-uh.
And a slam will do it. Larry Zbyszko, he's hot, and Adnan El Casey is confused, and I would probably think a little bit frightened.
Well,
realistically, in order for Sheik Adnan El Casey to win this match, he's got to slam Yukon John, 308 pounds.
And the Sheik goes 267. Yes, the Sheik has to do the impossible.
Yep.
And
Gary DeRuscia, he's taking the ring garb, the ring attire off of Sheik Adnan El Casey.
Like it or not.
On, you got to do it.
Like it or not, pal, right. You're in. Like it or not, you are in. You are the second man. And he's thinking as he's signing the deal, Coquina will be here.
Yeah.
It's a standard thing. My name's on it. It's always on it. So what?
Yep.
Not in his wildest hallucinations could he have imagined that he would be in the ring right now against Yukon John Nord. I mean, I'll tell you what. The song says all is quiet on New Year's Day.
Yeah, right. Yukon John, he's tracking him just like he tracks the wolves up in the northern recesses of the Yukon territories in Canada. Oh, John Nord. It wasn't that very long ago when people didn't have a whole lot of use for Yukon John. He says, admittedly, I ran with the wrong kind of people. Ran with Bruiser Brody. Ran with Adrian Adonis. Didn't live a very exemplary life. He wanted to change. He says, now, I read the Bible. I work hard. I'm still rough and tough, but I'm a changed man.
Sheik, a fashion statement, I might add.
Oh, yeah.
By the way.
Uh-huh.
You know? Zbyszko having a few words with Sheik Adnan El Casey, the world heavyweight champion, looking on as the slam match is about to get down to business. The Sheik has to do the impossible.
That's right.
Plain and simple. Slam. I mean, big Yukon John.
Let's take nothing away from Sheik Adnan El Casey.
No, not at all.
a tremendous wrestler over the years.
Tremendous career.
He's had a spectacular career.
Yes.
But you mentioned doing the impossible. Pinfalls don't count.
Uh-uh.
We're not doing anything on the point system. Disqualifications don't count. Countouts, forget it. The only way that this match will be won or lost is one of these men will slam the other one in the ring or outside of the ring.
Boy, this is the kind of matches that have exemplified the Team Challenge series.
Absolutely right. In fact, next week on ESPN, you are going to see a whole series of Team Challenge series type of matches. You'll see things like the six-man tag team battle royal. We've got the Greco-Roman battle royal. And we've got a football clash. That one is going to be incredible.
Yeah.
That one's coming up for you next week on ESPN. In the meantime, John Nord, UConn John, he's putting the boots to Sheik Adnan LKC. And I don't know if he's just trying to wear him down or somehow getting irritated where he can get him in a position to pick him up and slam him.
Well, let me also say this, that the Sheik has not had time to properly prepare his program, you know, and be able to assess a strategy. He's doing it on the fly.
Oh, absolutely. I think he walked out here.
Yeah. Not expecting to be a combatant.
No, prepared to manage Coquina Maximus.
So,
did we ever determine where Coquina was?
I don't know. It was New Year's Eve.
Yeah.
And, you know, your guess is as good or better than anyone's.
Into the ropes goes Sheik. Shoulder tackle and down goes the Sheik.
Yep. Well.
You just heard Mike Shields, our producer, has just informed us that there's a flight delay out of Chicago. That's hardly unusual.
No.
I mean, anybody that's made that trip into and out of either Midway or O'Hare, hearing that there's a plane delayed out of Chicago can certainly empathize and understand what's happened to Coquina Maximus. But I don't think...
I think there's some strategy here. Look out.
The Sheik's not buying it.
Nope. The Sheik came in and snuck up on UConn John Nord. Zabisco distracted Nord and the referee.
Rake of the eyes by Sheik. You know, he can rake the eyes all day long, raking the back by those fingernails. Gary DeRusha saying that's not it. You gotta slam him. Boot to the face by UConn John. Thundering right forearm by John. Another right forearm by UConn John. Into the ropes goes Sheik. Shot off the ropes. Another foot right into the kisser. And Sheik is rocked.
Sheik is now saying, okay, champ, you gave me the advice, now what do I do?
Now understand this too, Ralph and fans. Sheik's out on the floor, but that doesn't mean that UConn John can't go out there and slam him. It's anywhere in the ring or anywhere on the floor.
Yep.
It is a slam match. UConn John having a talk with Baron Von Raschke, getting some advice from the Baron, the team captain. Those of you following the Team Challenge series, watching it on All Star Wrestling and reading all about it in Pro Wrestling Illustrated and Wrestling Fury and all the great magazines covering this sport, know all about Team Challenge. And Baron Von Raschke, captain of the team on which UConn John is now a participant.
Baron's Blitzers,
indeed. And we're anxious to show you more of those Team Challenge Series matches. Sheik going for the slam.
Look at that.
He's trying for the slam. Nord going for the slam. And Baron's hot. He thought Big John had it locked up.
Yeah.
Baron thought that UConn John had it. And now Baron, he's drawing it up with Sheik Adnan LKC. UConn John just waiting for the Sheik to somehow show himself.
This is a chess game.
Yep. That's exactly what they're doing right now. The Sheik, he tried to slam UConn John, didn't quite work out. As we were talking about the ESPN show of next week, where you're going to see all those great Team Challenge Series style of matches, the same type of matches that make up the great Team Challenge Series that wrestling fans all over the world are talking about. Sheik working on the left arm of UConn John. That's got to be a wear down move, I would think.
Yeah. Like Bobby Fischer, the great chess master.
Yep. Well, which one's Bobby Fischer and which one's Boris Spassky?
I don't know. I was going to say.
Into a standing arm wringer. But again, that's not going to do it.
Well,
she could submit, and that's not going to end the match.
There's no one in the match. You have to slam the other player. And
she going for the eyes. Going for the eyes of UConn John.
Sheik trying to do as we build the impossible, not to take anything away from the Sheik, but to slam Nord.
Larry Zbyszko, he's still cheering the Sheik on. I think he thinks if he can wear UConn John down, that's his best chance to just pick him up. And if he can just barely get him over, that's still a slam in the ring or outside of the ring.
Piece by piece, peck by peck.
Well, you know, they say the best way to remove an elephant from the road is a piece at a time.
That's right.
And that's exactly what Sheik is trying to do. And look at the determination by UConn John.
Look at Nord.
Double sledge to the back by the Sheik. Another double sledge. Sheik's laughing. Sheik thinks he's got... He thinks he's got John compromised. And look at the look now on the Sheik of Pace of Adnan LKC. Double chop. Another double chop.
Oh!
Right hand by John. Another right hand by John. And now he's chasing the Sheik around. If he catches him, all he's got to do is slam him, and this one's over. In the ring or outside.
Sheik running for cover. Around Zbyszko.
UConn John has just nailed Larry Zbyszko. And here comes John. Here's the Baron. Baron threatening with a claw.
Ah, he's seen that before.
He's got
it.
It
is. Look out.
It is over.
That's it.
That's all.
Big UConn John Nord from the Northwest Territories putting the final finishing touches.
Yeah. With great ceremony, great pomp.
Yeah.
He held him up for what seemed like an eternity. I'm sure it seemed like a week and a half for Sheik Adnan LKC. And I know I'm going down and I know it's going to hurt. Please.
And embracing.
Now look.
See the Baron in the background.
Exactly. Baron von Raschke threatening the claw. Sheik Adnan LKC turning away, and UConn John has got a hold of Sheik Adnan LKC going, look at this, Sheik. This is reality. Have a dose of it. Bam!
Boom.
And that, as they say, was that. Let's check in with John and Eric Bischoff.
You're a big one here, debuting Team Challenge Series action. Kind of a double surprise, though. You get your hands on Sheik at NLKC, kind of a belated Christmas present.
And it felt great. Let me tell you, I couldn't have picked a better man than the Baron. But I'll tell you what, me and Bertha's job ain't done here in the AWA. You got a lot of tough guys, a lot of wise guys going around thinking they're tough. Thinking they're real tough, but I got the man that I can count on. Loyalty. Loyalty. And we're gonna stick together. Ain't that right, that Daddy Baron?
I only got one thing to say. Oh!
There they go. There you have it. Baron von Raschke, the captain, and his new man, UConn John Nord, clearing out the bad timber here in the AWA. Stay with us. We'll be back right after this.
Welcome back. You know, I don't think UConn John Nord could have hoped for a better way to start off the 1990s than a body slam match with Sheik Adnan LKC. And I don't think the heavyweight champion of the world could think of a worse way to start out the 1990s than to have Mr. Saito chasing him around the world looking for another shot at the heavyweight championship of the world. Well, fans, next week, right here on ESPN, 4 o'clock Eastern, the entire hour will be devoted to Team Challenge Series-style matches. And we're talking about the Football Clash, a Greco-Roman rules amateur-style wrestling match, and a six-man battle royal, a tag team battle royal. That'll be our main event. Don't miss it. Well, for everyone here from the AWA, have a very, very happy new year. I'm Eric Bischoff. We'll see you next week right here, AWA Championship Wrestling.